taking these definitions and, hey, it's a rock thing, and that includes, I mean, our culture, it, there are like so many beautiful elements of it, and they're all connected, you know?
Which
so
makes it solid rock.
Yeah. That's nice.
Yeah,
you could do really like a whole production with artists and, I mean, you know, visual artists and creative artists and poets and music and...
Well, that's the key to the organization that we, everybody that's in our organization, we can all put our, you know, skills and our creativity together to do major productions along with producing ourselves.
I'm sorry. You mentioned how everybody is involved in this, and actually we're going to take a break for our case gallery here, and we have an artist who's a part of the RC named Martin Dixon, who did a wonderful series. In fact, we only have 20 slides, but he did 80 slides of styling and profiling.
That's right.
And it's like the generation gap of Detroit and New York nightclubs, and looking at our people as they enjoy. In fact, we're going to use your music. Why don't you tell us about Blues Time in America?
Well, Blues Time in America is the tune that our band, Michael Hill's Blues Band, contributed to the Black Rock Coalition album that's on Ryko Disc called The History of Our Future. And it sort of swings, has that groove that was inspired for me. I always loved Trouble Man by Marvin Gaye. Swings so nicely. And I always wanted to write a song like that. And this song has hopefully some of that flavor. And it talks about this country where you can, there's good reason to have the blues. And there's a little reggae, you know, flow in there and the guitar, you know. I play guitar and I sing lead.
This is a nice tune. I really like this. Mm-hmm.
And I have the good fortune of having my brother and my two sisters in the band, too.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah.
All right, we're going to break here and watch some of this really nice work with Martin Dixon. We'll be right back. We're going to talk about rap and rock. Enjoy.
So you look good on camera. You look good in person, too.
Just don't know how they're going to survive. People getting worried. They just don't know how they're going to survive. It's blues time in America.
Blues time.
Too many dreams are passing people by. People work their whole lives.
Working so
can't find a job because their future's been sold. Their whole
lives
can't find a job cause their futures are sold. It's blues time in America,
blues time.
Cause greed is out of control.
Everybody knows
blues time in America.
Blues time.
Hold on, people, keep the faith.
Hold on, people.
Blues time in America. Got to find a better way.
Got to find it.
Let's piggyback here now and talk about this wonderful release that BRC has put out called
The History of Our Future.
Tell me about it.
Well, The History of Our Future is on Ryko Disc label. It's a compilation album with 10 of the BRC bands on it, and it has a little bit of all kinds of sounds. It's like a menagerie of sounds. It's got that real bluesy thing. It's got a jazz type sound to it. Some of the groups have a kind of hard, what some people know as heavy metal sound. So
funk.
It's got the
it's
funk.
It's a little bit to please everybody, huh?
Yeah, it's a little bit to please it all. And it's all black compilation, you know, all the musicians on this.
Now, is this Ryko, you say?
Ryko Disc
is that
the label.
Ryko Disc is an independent label based out of Massachusetts,
yes.
And they're nationally and world distributed.
Okay, that's what I'm
And
they're,
about. Yeah, it's on CDs and cassettes, and,
okay.
And if your record store doesn't have it, ask them to order it.
That's
they
right.
can get it.
Right.
Okay, what is the connection, or is there a connection between, or can there be, or do you anticipate rap and rock in terms of your involvement? We know it's been done.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You know, Run DMC.
Well, there are rappers in the BRC also. You know, there are rappers who have their own bands and who work with live musicians as well. And so, I mean, to my mind, you know, rap is no more disconnected to rock from rock than rock is disconnected from blues. It's all a continuum,
right.
And it's all connected. And I mean, if you go back to people like Gil Scott-Heron, you
mm-hmm.
know, and who are the last poets, you
mm-hmm.
know, who are doing music with poetry, and so I mean, it's just a natural evolution, and we're all connected.
Which is a very African
Jared's
thing, anyway.
Doing some
yeah.
stuff too.
I mean, we're putting that into a practical sense concerning the new music seminar, which is coming up in June.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas anybody who's down with the rap scene knows that rappers are moving to live music now, live rhythm sections.
Right.
And we want to be sort of on the forefront of that too. So we're actually setting up a show with a number of name rappers who I can't mention now, but will be obvious when it comes out in the media very soon. And we're going to have two rhythm sections, and we're going to have these rappers come out and freestyle with the live rhythm sections, and hopefully that'll will you know, be an encouragement to other rappers to do the same, to get more live musicians involved.
Hmm. Do you have white guys in your groups as well?
Some of the bands have white members. The Black Rock Coalition is not closed to white members at all, you know, the bands are primarily black led. That's important, you know. But you know, a lot of our supporters and members of the BRC are white, and members of the bands as well.
What effect will like computers and drum machines and synthesizers and samplers and all of that have on effect the rock musician, do you think, in this time and in the future?
It really doesn't affect a real musician. You know, I mean, maybe it affects like people who are more scientists or of that nature. But I'm saying as a musician, you simply look at those things as tools. Just as you look as an instrument as a tool to basically express what you have inside and bring it out. And if you look at it as a tool, it's just, you know, either you can use it or you can't.
We have a film clip here from a commercial composite by BRC. Anybody want to talk about it?
Well, that was directed by Corbett Santana,
uh-huh.
And it's a compilation of different artists. And on this, I think we'll be featuring Trio from Beyond, one of the BRC bands, and mm-hmm. I, you know, all these bands, a lot of people are really good friends and family, and I, it's really nice to see their success. They're on
yes.
Epic Records now, and
Have
they're
an
currently
album.
Touring, opening for Ziggy Marley and the Melody Makers,
okay.
And their album is out on Epic, called it's called I, and great band,
yeah,
you know.
They're a wonderful
okay.
band.
Well, let's give you a look at two of the BRC bands, Trio from Beyond and I.
We'll be right back.
indeed.
How would I get in touch with you if I wanted to be part of PRC?
Well, there's a hotline number you can call. Tip you right in. This is a newsletter that we have as well for members that comes out and keeps you up to date on what's happening among different bands and artists of all stripes, writers, poets. And the hotline number is 212-713-5097.
Let me ask you this. What is your take on record labels and radio stations as they relate to BRC or just Black Rock?
Well, I know it's been kind of difficult getting some of our music played on certain stations, the stations that do carry the your basic rhythm and blues or reggae or even rap artists. It's been hard for us to get our music on these airwaves because a lot of times these radio stations don't feel that, you know, people will listen to it. They haven't given us the chance or even themselves to listen to it.
Well, there's a lot of fear in record companies and on radio stations. People are worried about sponsors and this, and they don't want to get too, you know, the industry puts forth the proposition that, you know, Black people and don't want to listen to this or that people aren't ready for that. And basically you have success stories that seem to come out of the blue that take the record industry by surprise, like Robert Cray and they're shocked, or Tracy Chapman and people are shocked, yeah. And Living Color and they're shocked, but they don't sort of put it together that there's a market for people playing other music than what they have thought that people want to hear. And so that fear factor, I mean, because people are worried about their jobs and people don't want to take risks, and radio stations don't want to offend anybody because they're scared of the, you know, they're worried about the sponsors and this and that. But that fear factor has to just be overcome.
There's so much more I want to talk about. Like, I want to talk about the alternative awards you guys are considering, but we got to wrap up unless you can say it in about 10 seconds.
I can't really say it in 10 seconds.
Okay,
have to come back.
Leave it. But this guy's got something that they've got cooking for an alternative award for. Maybe Soul Train Awards. We're going to close up here now. I'm Amafujo, and I'd like for you to set up our last record from PBR Street Gang.
All right. This is Didn't Live Long, which is on the Ryko Disc compilation album. It's basically about our youth, and this whole album was done in reference to our youth with them in mind. But it's called Didn't Live Long, and I'm singing lead vocals on that.
Okay, we're gonna leave you here with this song by PBR Street Gang. And I want to personally thank Jared Nickerson, Amafujo, and Michael Hill
for
being our
guests
from Black Rock Coalition. And special thanks to Martin Dixon for his work. I'm Fikisha Kumbo, and if you need any information about any of our guests or our visual artists, we're gonna flash our address on the screen. Okay? Thank you for joining us. I'm Fikisha Kumbo. We're going to see you next time. Stay tuned. Bye for now.
Killed the man who was his father, then decided to take his mother's life in his hands. Jamie!